Good morning. Bo, please remind me of the equation for power.
Flippin' physics.
Power equals work over time.
Work over change in time.
Right. Work over change in time.
Correct. And that this is work over change in time reminds us that this is what type of power, class?
Average power.
Right. Average power because it is over a time duration.
Not instantaneous power. Instantaneous power is at a specific time, not over a change in time. Right. Billy, what do you think the equation for instantaneous power is?
Well, average velocity equals change in position over change in time, and instantaneous velocity equals the derivative of position with respect to time. So, I think instantaneous power equals the derivative of work with respect to time. Right, Mr. B?
Absolutely, Billy. Instantaneous power equals the derivative of work with respect to time. Now, we also know that work is the dot product of force and displacement. That means an infinitesimally small amount of work, dW, equals the dot product of force and an infinitesimally small change in position, dr. We can substitute that into our equation for instantaneous power. We get that instantaneous power equals the dot product of force and the derivative of position with respect to time. And Billy already pointed out that the derivative of position with respect to time equals velocity. Therefore, we now have another equivalent equation for instantaneous power. It equals the dot product of force and velocity, which also equals force times velocity times the cosine of the angle between those two vectors. And realize, because this is instantaneous power, it is also the power delivered to an object as a function of time. And power does not have to be defined using work. It can be defined more generally using any type of energy transfer. Power equals the derivative, with respect to time, of energy transferred into or out of a system. For example, as we talked about before, energy can be transferred via waves, work, heat, electricity, or radiation. And the units for power are watts or joules per second because power is the rate at which energy is transferred into or out of a system. Bo, please rearrange the equation power equals the derivative of energy with respect to time to form an integral.
Rearrange the derivative definition of power to form an integral? What is that?
Remember, any derivative can be rearranged to be an integral.
No, that I do not remember.
You just multiply the derivative power equation by dt to get dE equals power times dt.
And then you just take the integral of both sides, because the left side is with respect to energy, it is from energy initial to energy final.
And because the right-hand side is with respect to time, the limits are just time initial and time final.
I'm not sure the word just should ever be used in any of those sentences. What do we do now?
Well, the integral of dE is just E with the same limits as before, which just becomes energy final minus energy initial.
Which just means change in energy equals the integral with respect to time of power from time initial to time final.
I think you all are getting a little arrogant with your justs.
Yeah, probably.
Did he say justs? Or jests?
Billy, surely you jest.
I never jest, and don't call me Shirley.
Just stop.
Okay, let's just...
jest.
No, get back to the physics.
Annoying.
Realize work causes a change in energy. In other words, we can replace change in energy with work. And now we have an equation for work just... in terms of power and time. Work equals the integral from time initial to time final of power with respect to time.
Hold up, Mr. P. I thought the general equation for work was
work equals the integral from position initial to position final of force in the x direction with respect to x.
Not to be confused with the dot product equation for work, which is work done by a constant force.
Right. That means we now have two integral equations for work. One integral work equation has to do with the force acting on an object and the change in position of that object. The other integral work equation has to do with the power delivered to the object and change in time. Two very similar looking, however, very different equations for work. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.
Just.